Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This is your girl Adriana DC. Tonight I am going to be bringing you all the most memorable fragrances in my collection. Now, I don't know what you guys consider to be memorable. I'm not going to be giving you guys heavy hitters, so to speak. I'm giving you fragrances that are both heavy hitters and fragrances with a very memorable scent profile. Each of these fragrances, they have a note in it that really, really stands out, that makes the fragrance really, really special. And for me, against any fragrances in my collection, if you smell it side by side, you will be able to tell or pick up that particular scent. Because for me, they all have outstanding notes or scent profiles that for me, it's very, very memorable. So yeah, if this is something that you guys are interested in seeing in my collection, then by all means, keep on watching. If you guys are new here, please do hit that subscribe button. Make sure to hit that notification bell so that way you will be notified every single time I upload. For those of you who are my returning subscribers, thank you guys for supporting me. I truly do hope you guys enjoy these selections. So the first fragrance that I want to tell you guys about is a perfume that has, it's one of the first and only perfumes in my collection that has a particular note. And that is Angel Shares by Killian. This is the only fragrance that I have ever smelled. I'm kidding. I think Bitter Peach also have it, has in cognac in it. But this is the only fragrance that I have in my collection that has an accentuated cognac note. Okay, this has an accentuated cognac note with that very prominent cinnamon essence, the vanilla and the tonka bean. I think there's some ambery touches in this perfume with some woodsy elements as well. For me, against any fragrance in my collection, like, this perfume stands out. I mean, there are perfumes that give you somewhat slight similar vibes to this fragrance, but I haven't smelled any dupes. Okay, for me, this fragrance stands out on its own, and within my collection, this fragrance is definitely identifiable. And if I was to smell, you know, this fragrance with my eyes closed, I think I would most definitely be able to tell, you know, the scent, because of, you know, how different it is and how accentuated that cognac note is. So Angel Shares is definitely one of the most memorable fragrances in my collection. The next fragrance that I also find quite memorable is, of course, the other flanker of the Angel Shares, and this is Roses on Ice. And even though this is a very simply elegant, classy, refreshing cucumber and rose smelling perfume, you gotta give it to them, you guys, for that cucumber note right there. I don't know, you know, I don't think, you know, this fragrance right here, I mean, I do have one fragrance that gives me similar vibes, but because of that cucumber note in here, it's just a different vibe. It's just something that you're not gonna come across all the time. It's not something, it's not a note that I see in any other fragrance in my collection. Yes, you can find fragrances that give you somewhat of a similar vibe. But for me, the make of this fragrance is definitely unique and definitely stands out. Once again, if I am to be blindfolded and I have to be made to smell this perfume, I don't think I'll be mistaken. Like, this perfume would definitely stand out amongst any and every fragrance in my collection. So for me, this is absolutely an extremely memorable smelling fragrance. The next memorable perfume in my collection is none other than Oud Bouquet, you guys. This is one of the first oud fragrances that I bought. I consider it to be one of the best oud fragrances on the market. And for me, that rose, vanilla, an oud combination with the praline, it is strong, it is sweet, it is unforgettable, it is mesmerizing, it is beautiful, truly an impressive smelling perfume. It smells classy, it smells seductive, it smells sweet. This is an outstanding perfume, and undoubtedly this fragrance, placed against any other perfume in my collection, like, it definitely stands out. I mean, This is one of the best sellers in this particular range, and it is so for a reason. This is an extremely memorable scent. Unlike all the others, this is a beast mode type of fragrance. And I want to say I'm so glad that the colder months are coming back into play to wear this perfume, because this fragrance is a knockout during the summer, the hotter months. In the colder months, this is a superstar, you guys. This is an absolute superstar, and this is a very distinguishable scent, very unforgettable, memorable smelling fragrance, you guys. So yeah, this is Oud Bouquet by Lancôme. The next memorable fragrance in my collection is none other than Lancôme by Givenchy. And from the very first day that I smelled this perfume, there was something so outstanding yet so beautiful in this perfume. This fragrance opens up with a hint of citrusy vibes to it, an accentuated jasmine and tuberose essence, like a very sweet jasmine essence in this perfume, and it's grounded by a beautiful earthy woody essence in this fragrance. This perfume makes me feel grounded, it makes me feel strong, it makes me feel settled. This is that type of perfume that you wear, you know, by the cabin, that you wear when you're going to a cabin in the woods. You know, you're gonna be sitting down, sipping on some coffee around the, you know, fireplace. This is the tone, the mood that this perfume, you know, kind of sets. And for me, it is very outstanding, you guys. It is a very outstanding, very memorable. And there is nothing in my collection that gives me this. Besides, I do have a fragrance that gives me a similar vibes, but because of that accentuated woody base, woody earthy touches in this perfume, no other fragrance has such a strong, beautiful, accentuated woody earthiness to it. For me, that's what truly makes this fragrance special. And for me, this is a very beautiful, memorable fragrance in my collection, you guys. So this is Lancôme by Givenchy. The next memorable fragrance in my collection is none other than Versace Dylan Blue Turquoise, you guys. Now, this is the only fragrance in my collection that has that accentuated guava note. And for what it's worth, you guys, you know, the somewhat simplicity of this fragrance, that guava note right there makes this fragrance stand out, you guys. I mean, against any fragrance in my collection, I mean, like I said to you, I sprayed this for my partner to smell once, and he said to me, this smells like guava, you guys. So even somebody who's not even accustomed to smelling perfumes and sniffing out fragrance notes and stuff like that, that guava, that beautiful guava essence in this perfume, it just sets this perfume up. It just sets this fragrance apart. It makes it stand out. It makes this perfume special. So for me, this is a truly special fragrance in my collection, even though it's, you know, it's an eau de toilette, a fresh tropical fruity smelling perfume. I just think it is a truly beautiful perfume that stands out on its own because of that guava note, you guys. So this is Versace Dylan Blue Turquoise. Next we have Angel Muse by Mugler, and of course, you guys, like, how could you not? This is your sweet hazelnut cocoa smelling perfume with a very strong patchouli note. There's some grapefruit in the opener of this fragrance, so it opens up kind of bright, a hint of citrusy elements, but that powdery chocolatey essence in this perfume, there is no other. I mean, there is none like this fragrance right here. I mean, like, this is Mugler. I mean, I could put Mugler entire brand here and it will stand out. But for me, this is a perfume that I went crazy over when I first smelled it. And I was so in love with this perfume, and I'm still in love with it. It is one of my most, like, identifiable scents in my collection. Like, standing up against anything in my collection. Like, I would be able to smell this perfume blindfolded and I would be spot on with this scent. I know this because of that very unique, identifiable, very memorable, unforgettable scent profile. Angel Muse is definitely a memorable fragrance in my collection. Next, we have Love Don't Be Shy by Killian. When I bought this perfume, I didn't know how to receive it, okay? There is an accentuated marshmallow note in this fragrance that is so divine, so beautiful, and so sweet, you guys. When I first smelled this fragrance, I didn't know how to receive it. I didn't know how to process it, but I do know that when I smelled it, it was definitely memorable. And for me, this is like such an outstanding fragrance, not just in my collection, but in the perfume community. I would say this perfume right here is such an unforgettable, beautiful, sexy, seductive, sweet, gourmand smelling fragrance that for me, this just stands out. Like I said to you, when I first smelled this perfume, I didn't know how to receive it. I didn't know how to process it. This is actually a perfume that I did not like when I first smelled it. And there are not many fragrances that I didn't like and I turn around and actually love that fragrance. But for me, when I smelled this perfume, I just didn't know how to receive it. It was different. Like I said to you, that marshmallow sweetness mixed with the orange blossom and the vanilla, the honey. It just stood out so strong, you guys. But I love this fragrance. And for me, this is truly an unforgettable smelling fragrance, you guys. So this is Love Don't Be Shy by Killian. Next, we have Roses and Chocolates by Mancera. And you hear the name of this perfume, I mean, people, I don't know, there's not many fragrances. I have never come across a perfume that smells like roses and chocolates. And when I saw this, this was like, just grab it. This was like a scent that I was like, I don't think I thought hard about this purchase. I just had to grab it. All I saw was roses and chocolates you get. And for me, this is sweet, dark, chocolatey smelling perfume. You get the essence of the vanilla. It comes across as a hint of caramel in here. Again, the chocolate comes off quite dark. There are some fruity notes in this fragrance. And again, you have the rosy touches. I think there's some mandarin in the opener of this perfume. There's some mandarin, some black currant. You don't really get the fruity notes in the opening. You get that in the base as this perfume begins to dry down. So the chocolate in here is so prominent and so strong. All I know, you guys, this perfume is like, it smells like a dessert. This is a true gourmand scent, which, you know, Mancera and Montel are definitely famous for. But this is truly an unforgettable. This is like the most different smelling fragrance in my collection. I want to say that richness, that bitterness, you know, that dark chocolatey essence. In some instances, it can be a little bit like, oh, you don't know how to take it. But when you spray it and it dries out on the skin, it is a beautiful scent. But truly an unforgettable, very memorable fragrance that stands out in my collection. And I can imagine wearing this perfume on date night and the fall and the winter months. Like, this perfume truly stands out. It is extremely different, you guys. Yeah, beautiful scent, you guys. So this is Roses and Chocolates by Mancera. The next memorable Mancera fragrance, as if all of Mancera fragrances aren't memorable enough, but for me, the next most memorable fragrance from Mancera is Holidays, you guys. Now, this smells like, you know, another coconutty smelling perfume. It is a sweet, syrupy, coconutty, tropical, floral smelling perfume. But the coconutty essence in here, that coconut scent in here, it stands out against every other coconut fragrance I have ever smelled, you guys. There are truly some beautiful coconut scents, you guys. But then there is Mancera Holidays. This just stands out. Now, it is not unique, but for me, the coconut, the way the coconut is done, I think it stands out. I don't know what it is, like if it's the, I don't know. Again, it smells like the coconut jelly. It smells like it just smells, it smells like the like an oil. It smells like coconut oil. That's it. It smells like coconut oil, if not the coconut jelly. And that essence that you get from this perfume, this is a very unforgettable scent. Okay, this for me, it stands out amongst all the other coconut fragrances. For me, this is a very special fragrance from Mancera and is truly a memorable fragrance in my collection, you guys. So this is Mancera Holidays. Last but by no means least, one of the most outstanding niche fragrance in my collection is Creed Aventus Fajar. I think this is one of the most outstanding and unforgettable niche fragrances out there. I actually think this is one of the best sellers from Creed as well, for all the good reasons. This is a heavy hitter. Now, like Oud Bouquet, this is long lasting, it is strong. This has sillage that is like this can fill up a corridor, a long haul corridor. The scent trail of this will follow you along the way. This is a beautiful, woody, citrusy smelling fragrance with the essence of lime. There are some fruity notes, but overall, you get the lime and the bergamot in the opening. You get slight leathery touches in this fragrance. There's some patchouli in here. There's a hint of green. I think there's a green apple in here that makes this perfume crisp, eerie, citrusy. But the woody aura is what stands out. It takes over this entire perfume. This is not a playful niche scent. So even though there's so many other niche scents in here, so this just is, this smells like the most expensive niche fragrance, and it's the most expensive niche fragrance in my collection, but it smells that way as well. There are a lot of niche fragrances out there that don't necessarily smell niche. They smell expensive, but this is crème de la crème, you guys. This is like, this just like, I'm telling you, this is like the first niche fragrance that I ever bought, and this has been like my favorite niche fragrance of all times. Like the scent profile, smell, the wearing experience, I mean, going up against every other fragrance here, so this perfume truly stands out. I mean, if you were to go to Selfridges and you can smell 50 perfumes and you smell Creed will blow you away, and it will stand out because I've done it. And it's crazy because, you know, people go crazy over niche perfumes. They love niche fragrances. And the most outstanding niche fragrances out there on the market, I don't know if it's niche, Tom Ford is one of the most outstanding scents on the market. And you might get, I don't think for me, Zorjaf and Tiziana and Mancera, they smell so similar that you can find more or less, you know, because they're riding off of each other's DNA, they can stand out and be very much memorable. But Creed, there is no other, you guys. So for me, these are my
Two.
10 most memorable. These are my 10 most memorable fragrances in my collection, you guys. So there you have it. I do hope you guys enjoyed these selections. If in fact you did, please do give me a big thumbs up. If you guys are new, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button, especially if you've made it to the end. And once again, to all my returning subscribers, thank you guys for supporting me. I truly, truly appreciate it. And until next time, see you guys in my next video. Bye.